Arts and Crafts. Time for some bobbins. So we start with these two in the thigh. Push through the holes that we made, and then you just flatten the bottom bit. And the next one. Flatten the bottom bit. Got two here. Now we need two here at the knee. And then we just need two brads to go just above the foot. But just keep them a little bit loose to start with. And we'll tighten them up a little bit later. All right, now time for the string. And I measured my string to be about, I think, 50 centimeters, roughly. So what I do first is grab the end and just tie a little loop in it. So, I'm gonna measure about 50 centimeters, 50 to 60, I'd say. You can always make it shorter if you need to. So the looped end is going to go around the bobbin that's right above the foot, and then we can flatten that bobbin now. Around the bobbin at the knee, and then into the thigh. And then we're gonna do the same for another piece of string. Okay, so we have our second bit of string, and we're just going to do the same thing. We're going to put it on the other bobbin that's right above the foot. Then we're going to flatten that one. Sorry, bobbin, brad. I'm getting mixed between my brads and my bobbins. Put it on the brad near the foot, and then we're going to loop it the opposite way to the other one. Okay, now it's starting to take some form. You can see how this mechanism is going to work. Up, down. Okay, so we've got the leg, but it needs something to go onto, otherwise you can't really do the mechanism and hold it at the same time. That's where we get our item from the cupboard and our zip ties. Okay, so we've got our leg now on our item from the cupboard, and you can see it's a little bit lifeless. But watch what happens when we pull these strings.
It was at this moment Mary Ellen knew that something wasn't quite right. And so begins the journey one must take with a craft that is not quite right. Nothing cuts deeper than a failure at the end of an impassioned creation. One must try and try again until... Oh no, still not right. That seems to have made it worse. Yes, fast forward. This is quite depressing. And keep trying until... Oh dear, it appears she's given up. That, folks, is the face of a girl with dreams dashed. Oh no, my mistake. A true artist is not deterred by obstacles. Renewed hope is in the air, and oh my, that doesn't look at all like it did, but innovation is the future, etc., etc.
Okay, so here is the basic finished product of our kicking leg. Now, I tried with a vinegar bottle, but it didn't quite sit properly. So what I've done is I've gotten the holder for our paper towel, and that's actually working quite well. So what we can see here is the string at the top, that represents the muscle that comes up through here and attaches on the top of the knee. Up here it would be basically the quadricep muscle. The string down the bottom here is representative of the hamstring muscle. So what we can see is when we pull the top string, this string is shortening. So what that represents is the shortening of this muscle. And what you can see is we're extending our leg, or we can see that the angle, which is on this side of the leg, is becoming smaller. then when we pull the bottom string, you can see the leg is then flexing, it's coming back down. This string is shortening, which represents the hamstring shortening, bringing these two sides closer together. Now I'm going to decorate my leg. You can choose any way to decorate your foot. It could be a soccer kick, it could be a football kick, they could be a dancer, maybe a ballerina. I'm going to see what I can come up with.
If you've tried this week's Anatomy Arts and Crafts, then send me some pictures through social media because I would love to see your creations.
Okay, let's delve a little deeper. So we all know that every living thing is made up of cells, right? We are made up of cells, and every part of our body is made up of different types of cells. Well, muscle cells are called myocytes. We have three different types of muscle, right? And what were they again?
Skeletal muscle, cardiac muscle, and smooth muscle.
Oh, he was actually listening. Today we are focusing on skeletal muscle. So here is a skeletal muscle cell. They're long and cylindrical, and compared to other cells in the body, they're huge. Okay, so to us they're microscopic, but they are up to 10 times the diameter of an average body cell. And don't even get me started on their length. In short muscles, they can be mere centimeters, but in long muscles, they can be dozens of centimeters. The reason they are so big is because they're formed by the fusion of hundreds of embryonic cells. Now we've talked about cells before, so we know that cells are made up of specific features, right? We have our cell membrane, cytoplasm, nucleus in some cells, and cellular organelles. Well, muscle cells are a little different. The cell membrane is known as the sarcolemma. The cytoplasm is called sarcoplasm. They have multiple nuclei, and they also have many mitochondria because they have such high energy requirements. And mitochondria are an integral part of energy production. They also have hundreds of thousands of myofibrils. Here's a bit of a rundown to bring it all together. So we have a muscle, and the muscle is made up of fascicles, which are basically a whole heap of muscle fibers wrapped in connective tissue. The muscle fibers are made up of myofibrils. We've gone over quite a bit about muscles today, and there's still so much more to know. Muscles come in all shapes and sizes. Thin, thick, long, short, massive, and teeny-weeny. There's an estimated over 650 skeletal muscles in our body. And guess what? It's our job to look after every single one of them. So stay tuned over the next few weeks as we will delve deeper into how to take care of our muscles. Until next time.